Now, 2015 marks a dual year in culture and cuisine for the UK and Mexico. Here tells us more is Mexican cheesemaker Kristen Schnepp of Gringa Dairy. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
So what is this cultural exchange that we're doing?
So we're celebrating Mexico in the UK and the UK in Mexico. It's an exchange of culture, commerce, food. It's very exciting for the entire year.
Why are we doing it?
Mexico has a long relationship with the UK. And so this is about celebrating that relationship. And it's also about increasing, frankly, our trade.
Doesn't Mexican cuisine have world heritage status?
It does.
It's the only cuisine in the world that does a lot.
Indeed.
So like the Dorset coastline, that's what we've got. They've got like that. They've got that.
But our cuisine in 2010, UNESCO declared Mexican food a cultural asset. So it's protected by UNESCO.
Protected in what way?
How Mexican food is.
What do you mean protected? How is it protected? What protected?
Like a landmark. Yeah. It's seen as something that has great cultural significance. So
right.
As a cuisine.
So it's not. So for example, something like certain cheeses, they have to be made in a certain place in a certain way. It's not protecting dishes per se.
No. It's just
acknowledging its importance.
The cuisine, yes.
Oscar Sub are making chilies and all sorts. I was really worried there. Knock at the door.
Hello,
sir.
Whoa.
You've been making nachos? Yeah, sorry.
And tell us about your business, because you are based in the UK.
Yes.
You're the only Mexican cheesemaker based in the UK until Alex goes home this afternoon.
The competition, I'm worried. So yeah, I started off as I was in banking for a long time, and I decided I wanted to do something different, and I decided I wanted to make cheese.
Same thing happens
as,
to me.
As one does. And so since we're really cleared on the cheddar front, I wanted to do something that I felt passionate about. And I grew up in the Central Valley of California, which has a very large influence of the Mexican immigrants over generations. So we saw that Mexican cuisine was really being adopted in the UK. The Brits loving Mexican cuisine.
Yeah, we do.
So as the quality and quantity of cuisine has increased, I figured they were going to want the dairy products.
I like that story, but for both of you, I don't understand where the bit comes where you go, I know what I'll do, I'll make cheese. I don't understand that.
I think you've got to really, really, really like cheese.
Yeah.
Did you always really like cheese?
It's almost like you knew I was coming. The amazing thing is, I've never seen this before.
Yeah.
You know, everywhere you go where there's a new word for cheese, there's a new thing for cheese. So like cheese means cheddar, fromage means camembert probably, formaggio means like parmesan maybe, queso means like a manchego, or this. I mean, I've never seen this. Very exciting.
That's fantastic. Why did you love cheese so much, though?
It's something I've always been passionate about, and I have no idea. You know, some people want to be an astronaut. I just always wanted to make cheese,
okay.
Which is random, I realise.
It is really tasty.
I love cheese. It enhances every meal, doesn't it? Any meal, put melted cheese on it, works.
Any meal.
Including
cornflakes, it works.
Any meal. So I was speaking to you before the show. Mexican cheese is mainly for cooking,
is
that right?
Yes.
Right. Okay, and food. So let's look at them then. What's this first one?
So this is queso fresco. That's fresh cheese in Spanish, and it's primarily a finishing cheese or a crumbling cheese. Mm.
So we can eat, though. It's mainly used in cooking. It's not that you can't eat it.
No, absolutely. No.
I like that.
Yeah, it's not like a
squeaker. It's a squeaker.
Yeah. It's a squeaker.
Like halloumi.
Yeah.
Mm. It is. It's like a less salty feta or a less dense halloumi, and you can use it like both.
Mm.
And so this is just a little dish of corn
delicious.
Salad. Thank you, yeah. They're very, very mild. As the cheeses are designed to be in the food, they either add a creamy element, they add a cooling element to accompany the food.
Mm.
That's delicious, isn't it?
It's really knockout. Like we're playing in South America a couple of years ago, and it's just the food we had in Mexico was just it's like Italy. You can't get bad food there. Everything street food's amazing, but like really sophisticated restaurants as well.
So how do you make a cheese like that?
It's very, very fresh, and so it goes from cow to plate in a day. So I pick up the milk at 4 a.m. make the cheese, and by the evening it's in the chiller.
Oh, so it's...
So does that also mean then that it doesn't last, that it has to be eaten?
This has a 12-day shelf life,
so
it's very, very fresh.
All right, so
that doesn't sound very efficient if you're making cheese then. I mean, it's delicious, but you surely want something with more longevity.
All these cheeses are very, very fresh, actually.
Are they? Okay.
Really, this one looks
like... So this is queso chihuahua.
The dog.
Yeah, do you know how hard it is to milk those little dogs? So Chihuahua is a state in the north of Mexico, and this is a cheese that comes from there, also called queso menonita. Mm-hmm. It's a melting cheese, and so it's one of the inspirations for Monterey Jack, which is used very commonly in American Mexican cooking.
It's not that far off of cheddar, a mild cheddar.
It's really not our Lancashire. So its difference is that, you know, when you melt a cheddar, it gets a little bit gloopy?
Yeah.
But this melts very, very smoothly and cleanly.
It's got a high water, it's not pressed as much.
No, it's really not. We actually press it by hand. I don't use a press, yes. So this cheese has a 60-day shelf life, and it's actually the oldest cheese that I have in terms of shelf life.
Mm.
So nachos, by the way, are very much of a Tex-Mex version.
Course, yeah.
And so they were invented in Texas sometime in the 50s,
oh, really?
I think.
Oh,
yes.
So you don't get them in Mexico?
You don't get them in Mexico. No, they're not very common.
Okay.
They are delicious, though.
Oh,
they are
delicious.
It's an invention.
Yeah. They should probably have cultural status as well, really.
They should.
Yeah.
Americans, especially Texans, they love their nachos. And you can put anything on a nacho.
It's also true. Okay, so our final one. This looks amazing. What is this, though?
So this is queso Oaxaca. Oaxaca is a state in southern Mexico, and this is a cheese that is made actually all throughout the country. So it's a pasta filata style, which means it's like mozzarella. And this is the only cheese I make with raw milk.
So how do you get this? Is this the traditional way that it would always be presented?
There's several different shapes, but this is a traditional shape. And so you take the curd after you acidify, and then you stretch it in 80 degrees centigrade water into really long ropes. I have two layers of gloves. It's very glamorous.
They do it with their bare hands in Italy. It's a real art.
It's a real art. And you see people in Mexico, they'll string it from arm to arm. I'm not that good at it. But you stretch it into long ropes, salt it, and then wrap it up by hand. So this is a cheese that they commonly use for quesadillas and also kids' snacks. A friend of mine calls it a posh cheese string. It's very, very common in Mexico.
Great,
and when you meet Mexican expats, it's the cheese they ask you for first.
That is fantastic. So are there no strong cheeses in Mexico?
There are strong cheeses in Mexico, but many of the most common cheeses, and frankly these are some of the most common, tend to be fresh.
Okay. And how many different ones do you make?
I just make three.
Okay. I mean
we've
got to do best in show. I'm struggling a wee bit.
I'm going that.
Oh.
Delicious. Well, they're all delicious.
Yeah, they are all really good, aren't they? Well, look, this is just beautiful.
Yeah, I think that alone for the way that
it looks. That's coming home with me, that one.
Yeah, that's superb. Brilliant.
Thank you.
Lovely. Christian, thank you very much indeed. Now, after the break, we're cooking monkfish with quark season.